G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, which is part two of the series on wall bracing, we're going to work out the wind pressure for both our wind directions. Okay, so paragraph 8.3.4, racking force, says that the racking force of a building shall be determined by using the method outlined by in this clause, or by using the alternative method in Appendix F. Now, the alternative method is a simplified procedure, and it's going to give you a more conservative or safer solution. So it's going to require more bracing. So we're going to go with the more economical type, which would be this one here. So the total racking force for each story or level of the building shall be the product of the projected area of elevation of the building multiplied by the lateral wind pressure determined from table 8.1 to 8.5. The total racking force shall be calculated in both directions, long and short sides of the building. So that's why we do two wind directions, one on the long side, one on the short side. Okay, so the formula to work out wind pressure is done in kilonewtons, and the formula is the total racking force equals the area of elevation in square meters times by the lateral wind pressure in kilopascals, which is what we're going to work out now. I'll show you how to look that up. Okay, so it said there's four tables or five tables. So table 8.1 is for single story or upper story, or the upper of two-story buildings, lower story and subfloor of a single story or two-story, all vertical surfaces, gable ends, skillion ends, flat wall surfaces. So if your building's got a flat gable or a skillion, you would use 8.1. 8.2 is a single story or upper story of a two-story building, the long length of the building with a hip or gable end, which is going to be applicable for us, for our long side of the building. 8.3, the lower story or subfloor of a single story or two-story. Okay, so this is for the bottom floor on a two-story house, long length of the building, so it's not going to apply to us. 8.4, single story or upper story of a two-story building, short end of the building. So this is going to apply to us, so we're going to use 8.4. And 8.5, again, is for the short end of the building on the lower story of a two-story house. So you have to make sure you pick the right table for the building that you're actually going to be working this out on. So we're going to use 8.2 for our long side and 8.4 for our short side. So this is the table, basically, okay? So you need a little bit of information. You need to know what your pitch of your roof is, and you need to know how wide or how long your building is. Okay, so this is table 8.2, which we're going to call wind direction 1, and this is acting on the long side of the building. All right, remembering that our building, the building that I'm using for this series, it had a pitch of 30 degrees, it was 14.840 meters long and 7.270 meters wide. Okay, so this is the example. So if we look at the column for 30 degrees, and then of course we're looking at the long side of the building, and our building's 14.8, we're going to have to use 15. So we end up with a wind pressure, a lateral wind pressure, for this building of 1.1 acting on the long side of the building. All right, so we'll write that down somewhere, 1.1, and then we'll look at the short side. So the short side, we're using 8.4, and this will be our wind direction 2. Short side of the building, similar table, just different figures. Again, 30 degree building, so we're going to use the 30 degree column. And our building's only 7.2 wide, so we'll have to use 8. We can't go under, so we'll use 8 as our building width. And we get a lateral wind pressure on the short side of 1.2. Okay, so we can write those down. Wind direction 1. We're going to get a lateral wind pressure of 1.1 kPa, and wind direction 2, we get a lateral wind pressure of 1.2 kPa. Okay, so now we know what pressure the wind's going to put on those elevations. We can, in the next video, we'll work out the area of those elevations, and then we can calculate our racking force.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.